Lynchburg Foundry proudly brings you this issue of the Science Screen Report. The nation's leading independent foundry has been a growing part of the Lynchburg community since 1896. We manufacture quality engineered castings using 2800 degree molten iron and automated equipment to shape intricate parts. Chemical and physical analysis form the backbone of Lynchburg's quality control program. Precision castings are used in a variety of industrial and consumer products. Experience, technology, quality, and the foundry's greatest asset, people, have combined to make Lynchburg Foundry the leader in its field. And now, the Science Screen Report.
The Science Screen Report. Developments in science, engineering, and medicine that help solve the problems of modern life. Centuries ago, poets in Asia wrote of a glowing light in the sea. In 300 BC, the Greek philosopher Aristotle recorded, things, though they are not in their nature fire, yet that seem to produce light. In recent times, this ghostly underwater aura has provoked the curiosity of many scientists. Today's researchers call this light bioluminescence, light produced by living organisms. An eerie and beautiful phenomenon, bioluminescence is under study both as a scientific mystery and as a tool for medical diagnosis, light and energy production, and other uses. The complex and subtle world of the oceans has challenged man's intellect with its many riddles, few of them more puzzling than the living light called bioluminescence. Much early research into bioluminescent life forms centered around a few land insects, like the glowing, blinking firefly. Glowworms such as the Brazilian railroad worm, which shines in two colors. And luminescent mushrooms and other fungi. Certain fish, invertebrates, and deep sea life were also known to be bioluminescent. In the 1950s, the French United States research submersible Trieste allowed men to observe them in their home environment. As the diving vehicle descended below 300 meters, the Navy scientists aboard began to perceive the dim flashes of light. At greater depths, glowing single-celled life gave way to glowing jellyfish and other exotic luminous life forms. The research vessel's floodlights illuminated the seafloor, revealing glowing life as deep as 7 kilometers underwater. Later, research submersibles with greater mobility enabled ocean scientists to increase their knowledge of various underwater light sources. Besides the deep ocean depths, shallow bodies of water, such as Phosphorescent Bay in Puerto Rico in the Caribbean Sea, have been found to hold exceptional concentrations of glowing life. A night swimmer moving through such a body of water stimulates this life, causing the water to flash and luminesce. Shallow water bioluminescent life forms have been collected for study. Microscopic life forms no bigger than needle points swarm year-round. On moonless nights here, the wake of a boat glows so brightly that the 60-acre inlet was given the name Phosphorescent Bay. Columbus, on his first trip to the New World, recorded similar marine bioluminescence in the Bahamas. Currently, U.S. Navy-sponsored research into bioluminescence is underway at several institutions, including the University of California, Hawaii's Coconut Island Marine Laboratory, and the University of Singapore. Additional fact gathering is carried out in the ocean environment via scuba diving and other techniques. Many questions can only be answered in the sea. How are bioluminescent life forms distributed? What are their patterns of movement, sources of nutrition, links to the food chains and other aspects of the water environment? Such puzzles are not only problems for scientists. Their answers may hint at uses for bioluminescent phenomena as tools in medicine or as light and energy sources. Several natural functions for living light have been suggested. Detecting and luring prey. Inter and intra-species communication. And startling or otherwise confusing predators via light displays. Bioluminescence may often involve the symbiotic interaction of several life forms. This Japanese pinecone fish glows because of the presence of luminous bacteria. This light serves to both attract mates and illuminate prey. San Francisco's Steinhardt Aquarium collection includes the rare flashlight fish, which lives in the Indian Ocean and the Red Sea. The spots on the fish are colonies of luminescent bacteria. Interestingly, closely related species have very different ways of controlling their light organs. One raises a dark curtain to turn off the glow. The other rotates the light organ into a deep pocket beneath the eye. At the University of California in Santa Barbara, bioluminescence is being probed by Dr. James Cape.
Today, with these organisms here, which are cylinderates, finatulids, soft corals, which is of use to us because it has a very simple nervous system which extends throughout the entire colony and which seems to give off light whenever it's active. Mr. Satterley here is recording now from an animal, and he also has a device which collects light from the animal. On the oscilloscope screen here, we see the result of the experiment. On the lower trace, we see stimulus artifacts, and we see on the upper trace the consequence of this, namely three pulses of light in response to three pulses of electrical current. Therefore, this experiment shows that electrical activity in the nervous system of the animal is associated with the generation of light. The next question that we need to know is, how does the nervous system accomplish this fact? And to get at that, we're going to turn to the fish Perichthys. John, do you want to hand me some adrenaline there, please? This fish is the California midshipman fish. It has over its ventral surface on the order of 700 tiny photophores, which are controlled by the nervous system. These are not bacterial photophores. They're endogenous to the fish. The experiment we're going to do for you now is to demonstrate that adrenaline is probably the hormone that is released by the nerve endings to produce light. Do you want to inject the fish? And in a few seconds, the fish should be glowing brilliantly. If the hypothesis that adrenaline is the link between the nervous system and the photophore is true, we'll take this fish into the dark room now and see if it lights up. In response to this particular dose of adrenaline, the fish will probably glow steadily for several hours.
Another line of research is concerned with how bioluminescence relates to surface light. Below the curved glass container is a sensitive light monitor. Its measurements reveal that the light level from the underside of the fish is constantly adjusted to approximate the light level from the surface at that depth, making the creature almost invisible to predators below. Research is also underway on useful applications for bioluminescence. In one experiment, these sea pansies were used to determine the chemical activator for bioluminescence in several species. The findings were applied in a new technique for diagnosing human nerve diseases. They were also used to make measurements of critical components of human blood, clues to the existence of cancer, or the extent of heart problems. The biological production of heatless light is perhaps the most efficient energy conversion process known. In most underwater species, the light produced is blue, the color that travels farthest through water and is most easily seen by fish. Someday, perhaps, this light process may be used to provide safer, more efficient illumination in mines and tunnels, and perhaps even brighten homes and cities. Today, science is beginning to gain an understanding of the mysterious organisms that create their own cold light, and to apply this knowledge to diagnosing disease, producing energy, monitoring chemical processes, and other uses for the benefit of mankind.
Lynchburg Foundry has been proud to bring you this issue of the Science Screen Report to further your understanding of science, engineering, medicine, and technology.